Alright, Scalz 311 here, back with Knights of the Old Republic. And we are heading into the Sand People Enclave here. We need to put on our Sand People uniforms that we got. We only remember to put them on actual human characters. You don't need to put them on the droids. So HK doesn't need one.
Yes?
Alright, so this is the third of four videos where I have to do commentary post-recording because it got screwed up in an earlier during that time. So, conversation-wise, hopefully I like to try to say what it is I select so you know how it's going, conversations, but hopefully I remember. And if not, I apologize. Alright, so this is pretty much like the light side way to do this. If you want to just kill all these guys, you technically can, and just kill all the sand people, but obviously that's not the light path. So we're going to come in here in more of a diplomatic way.
Yes?
Alright, so we head into the Sand People territory, which is a pretty big area with really nothing in it, except a few mines here or there.
I'm here.
Ready.
And some Sand People to fight. They're pretty spread out, and like I said, if you're doing it the other way, where you're forcing your way through with the violence, you would probably have to fight all these guys. I've never actually done it that way, so I really don't know. And I try to recover that mine for some reason, thinking maybe he'll be able to pull it off, but his demolitions is not good enough yet to do that. I think there's a plus 10 bonus to the difficulty of the mines if you try to recover them, as opposed to just disable them. So that's why he keeps failing at it. Yeah, so this is a very large area, as you see. The Enclave is in the distance there. And like I said, if you're doing this the violent way, you would fight these sand people, I could only assume, right? Because like I said, I've never really done it that way. But they also have tons of turrets up there, so I really don't know how you would get past it. If the turrets shut down, or if there's a way to shut them down, I really can't help with that. But you see, they are pretty spread out, so even if you did have to fight them, you really probably want to take off maybe two at the most at a time. Or, you know, so it wouldn't be very difficult to do. There's a life support pack there in that one, and there's really nothing else to loot either. Pretty empty area, just a lot of mines to worry about. If for some reason your awareness was horrible, you want to see the mines. Other than that, I don't see how everybody in your party's awareness could be so bad not to see the mines in this area. Here it would actually probably get two, maybe three guys coming at once. But they're all warriors too. I don't know if they all are. He's a warrior. Warriors are pretty easy. It was the elites that were tough. Tougher. Alright, so we got a parts and credits there. So now we can head on in. Yeah, see, those turrets are the ones I'm talking about. I'm not sure if you would just have to probably destroy them, I would assume. I really don't know. I guess. I don't see how they would turn off otherwise. I didn't see anything out there that would be a switch or something. Okay, so this guy's not stupid. He's astounded that you're here. Your disguise may allow you to pass the turrets, but it is ineffective at close range. So you gotta use HK here to help talk. That's why you need HK to talk your way through this, even though he's evil.
One moment. I believe I understood that, Master. It may not have been his intention, but he did actually communicate something.
Quickly, tell him we are not a threat.
Translation. Result. I believe I have succeeded in confusing him, Master. We have shown an interest not common among outsiders.
Apologize for being here. Say we want peace.
Translation. Translation. requires that he report to his chieftain. Extrapolation. It would seem that we are at least worthy of curiosity for the moment. I would much rather this get bloody, Master, but it is your call. Translation. I can translate with some guarantee of accuracy that he is demanding to know why he should let us survive this encounter, Master.
Tell him we want a peaceful solution.
Translation. Translation. He claims he has no reason to believe you, Master. Your kind have tainted this land with machines and uncaring, ignorant feet. Translation. He requires proof of good faith. We must make a contribution to his people that shows we are not a threat. Shall I blast him now, Master?
Ask what it is he wants.
Translation. Translation. He plans to move his people farther from Anchorhead, but they need to build up stores of water first. He says you must aid him. Translation. He wants moisture evaporators from the Zerka. If you deliver them, he will order that his people reduce their attacks on miners.
Tell him we will get his evaporators.
Translation. Translation. He does not believe you, Master. We will only be allowed to re-enter the Enclave when we have the evaporators with us. Translation. We are to be escorted outside. He will wait, but he doesn't believe we are coming back.
Alright, so now that we're outside, we can put our clothes back on. As much as I... No, I'm not gonna say it. Jedi Knight robe for me, I believe, is the best one right now. And then... She's wearing the Dark Jedi robes.
Yes.
Okay, so we can warp back to our ship from here, which will speed up the process. Return to the Ebon Hawk. The problem is that we can't warp back to this area, because once you leave the immediate area of the Ebon Hawk, it actually goes back to Ebon Hawk, not transit back. So while we can warp here, which speeds it up, we actually have to run all the way back. Be nice if they had some kind of transit system or something, but they don't. So we gotta work our way to the Zerka office, which is right there, and talk to the guy at the counter. Even though I think I talked to the girl first on accident. Well, not really on accident. I just wasn't sure who to talk to.
Greetings again from the offices of Zerka Corporation. Is this about bounties or something else?
I have to go. Goodbye.
Farewell, Zerka.
Yeah, yeah. What do you have available for purchase?
Baba Hassan Shan.
Do you have any moisture evaporators? To exchange with sand people to stop their attacks.
Agi inko tune chunamuri ki mulira kun king. Don hit wama.
Alright, I'll take him for 400. Alright, so we got 100 experience, looks like. 400 credits lost. Got our evaporators. And we actually got enough points to level up. Which I think I'm gonna do when I leave here. I think I asked about the bounties, because I couldn't remember what that was, but I think that's actually for the Gaffy sticks, if we were doing it. Any Gaffy sticks that we bring back, we can get what are the bounties, but we're going to get his Gaffy stick back in a nice way. Okay, so I'm going to level up here real quick. We get to level up, which is nice. So we're going to go with Wisdom, helps with our Force powers, make sure they don't get resisted as often. Skills, we really don't have any points. So, I think I put it in Treat Injury, even though I should probably keep going with Persuade, because I'm going to be using Cure mostly for Treat Injury, even though I could still use them. We do a Force Persuade, but sometimes the Jedi guys get pissed off when we use it, so Persuade may still come in handy at times. Alright, and then Powers, I really can't remember what I picked. I don't think I picked Heal yet, even though I was looking at it pretty good here, I think. Yeah, I think I did, though. Well, plus 4 bonus to defense instead of the plus 2 and saving throws from the one that we already had. Yeah, Force Shield, okay. And accept. So now we gotta make our way back to the Enclave. And we can't warp there. So I'm gonna night speed myself, and then I'll see you when we get back to that area. Alright, so we are back here at the, right just outside the Enclave. Using some night speed to get through this faster. And we don't need our outfits on because they actually know about us now. So we need to talk to this guy actually. And he'll let us in, I believe. He's disgusted by our presence among his people. Yeah, well, I got your water evaporators, dude.
Extrapolation. This guard doesn't appear honored to have the job of greeting us.
Tell him we have the moisture converters.
Translation. Translation. He will take us before the chieftain, as he was instructed to do. Translation. He did not expect us to return, Master. He wonders if we have brought the moisture evaporators.
Tell him that we have his evaporators.
Translation. Translation. He does not trust you, Master, but you have done more than any other outsider. They will not attack, and he grants you his chieftain's gaffy as reward. Translation. The attacks will be reduced, and he will allow you to explore this enclave, but be warned that any lack of respect will result in death.
I have a few questions for him. Now we gotta try
Protocol.
To get the...
If you truly want this sadly peaceful arrangement to continue...
Remember Missions Brothers here and the Jawas. Ask. So ask about... Well, first ask about the star map.
Translation.
He'll actually tell us where the star map is.
Translation. He says that what you seek is far from here in the Eastern Dune Sea. He will give you a map so you can find your way. Translation. His people found it but didn't scavenge it because a crate dragon took up residence in the excavation.
A crate dragon? What is that? How do I pass it? Actually, I don't know if I ask that. I might ask about other
Protocol.
Questions.
We should not keep him long. It is an insult to take too much of his time. Unless the plan is to blast him when you are done, of course.
Yeah, we didn't ask about that. Let's see. Ask about captives.
We must be more specific, Master. They capture many organics.
Okay, ask about the Jawas.
Translation. Translation. He says that the captive Jawas are slaves and that they have lived past their usefulness. You may take them if you wish.
Ask if he knows about Mission's brother, Griff.
Translation. Translation. He says that by his very presence, this Griff defiles their home and land. He is without any semblance of usefulness to them. Extrapolation. I would assume we are free to take him. It is doubtful they will even waste the effort to kill him. Perhaps we could do it, Master.
Okay, tell him farewell for now.
Translation. Translation. We are free to leave.
Alright, so 400 XP. Got the Gaffy Stick as well, which we give back to the Zerka rep to finish that part, that quest. These sand people, I'm pretty sure if you loot the sand, the wicker baskets, they will attack you. That's what he says, by be careful about what you do, or be respectful. There are some other things, like rock piles we can loot, but the actual baskets themselves will I believe I try it here. I do a quick save and I try it and then reload when they attack. Yeah, they don't like the baskets. So we would have to start brawling, which we are trying to be nice. So let's load that back up. I just wanted to make sure that was true. That's what I remembered it being, but... Okay. So we need to find the Jawas and Griff. So basically just run around here. There's a little bit of things to loot. I don't think there's anything really worth much. Like that rock pile here, we can actually loot this and they won't care. We get Bantha Fodder. Bantha Fodder is actually useful to part of the main quest here later on in this. It's coming up soon though, actually. We're almost done here. A little bit left. Alright, nothing in here. We find our captives, set them free. Basically one big circle, and the other half, the other side of the circle is where the captives are. So there's Griff.
You there. I'm a high-ranking executive at the Zerka Corporation. There's a big reward if you take me back to Anchorhead. So, you're here to save me, right? I'm sure you'll get a huge reward. Yes, indeed. Mission always said some people would pay to find me.
You know, Mission? Who
Griff.
Are you?
You know her? Are you from Zerka Corporation? Please, tell me what's going on here.
I know Mission. She's here on Tatooine with me.
I'm her brother. She's alive? I can't believe it. When I heard about Taris, I thought the worst. Come on, take me to her. Get me out of here.
The said people said you can go run to Anchorhead.
What? No speeder escort? Okay. Okay, I should just take what I can get. I sure would like to see Mission, though. She's probably waiting for you on the ship you used to come to Tatooine, right? I think I'll go to the spaceport and see her. She'd like that. Thanks again. Oh, and don't tell Mission I'm coming. I want it to be a surprise when I show up at the spaceport. I can't wait to see the look on her face.
Yeah, I don't think she's gonna like you as much as you think she is, buddy. Alright, he does have something to loot in here. What has he got? Computer spikes, credits. You would think Griff would have at least took the credits off of that dude if he was in there with him. The way he acts. And here's our Jawas. The same people said you can go. Run to Anchorhead. Alright, 150 XP, like you said, for that. And we are done here. So we gotta head back and talk to the Jawas to get a reward for saving their guys. Head back to the ship. Even if Mission's... I think if Mission was in our group, they would have their little powwow here. But since she's not... as long as we just go back to where the ship is, the dock, they'll do it there. We don't let Griff back on our ship, that's for sure. Let's head back to the Ebon Hawk. Or not. Oh, we save first, just in case.
Mission? Is it really you? I heard Taris was destroyed. I thought you were dead. Oh, joy of joys, my little sister is alive.
I have to ask you something, Griff.
I don't know why nobody has clothes
on. It's important. I ran into Lena. She said it was your idea to leave me on Taris. It isn't true, is it?
Well... there's the truth, and then there's the truth, you know? I always meant to go back to Taris's just as soon as I had the credits to pay off my debts. But credits have been hard to come by.
You mean it's true? It was your idea to leave me there? I'm your sister. How could you abandon me like that?
Come on, sis. You didn't need me to look after you anymore. You may have been young, but you knew how to take care of yourself. Besides, you're here now. I mean, everything worked out fine.
That's it? That's all you have to say to me after all these years, after deserting me on Taris?
That and, you look good, sis. Like you're doing well. Financially, I mean. So, you think you could spare me a few credits to get back on my feet, do you?
You're hitting me up for credits. I don't believe this. Lena was right about you, Griff. We should have just left you to the sand people. Don't talk to me anymore. Ever.
Hmm. That didn't go well. Sis was always a little too fiery for her own good. She'll cool down in time.
I can't remember what I say. What now, I think? Or now what?
You may have saved my life, but I don't have a single credit to my name. Say, you wouldn't be able to spare me some credits just till I get back on my feet, you know?
Jesus, dude, seriously. I think we give him 100.
That's it, huh?
What?
Figured you'd be able to spare a bit more than that. You know, I'll take whatever I can get. Don't worry about me. I've already got a job waiting for me. Krita, the manager over at the Zerka supply shop, said I could come work for him if I ever get tired of the mines. Yeah, I think I'll go take him up on his offer. You know, maybe there's something else you can help me with. I need to talk to a guy first and set up the details, but if you're interested in a job, come see me in Krita's shop. Goodbye, Mission. I'm glad you're not dead.
Glad you're not dead. Okay, so now we gotta turn in these quests. The Jawas and the Zerka's shop. And see what Griff wants. Since we're gonna be going to the Zerka's place anyway. He should be there. That's pretty much it. Sand people's done once we turn the stick in. And then we have to work on the star map coming up. We're pretty much done. With Tatooine, that is. Alright.
Ah, just the person I was hoping to see. Mission didn't come with you, I see. Oh, guess she's still mad at me. Oh, well, it's probably for the best. This job is more up your alley anyway.
What's the job?
As you may know, tack glands can be refined to a very potent powder. It's the primary ingredient in Tarisian ale. That's what makes it so strong. Of course, now that Taris is pretty much wiped from the face of the map, Tarisian ale has become somewhat scarce and very, very valuable. Luckily, I know the secret recipe.
So what do you want to open a bar?
I know this guy. He's with the exchange. Now, if I give him a small sample of Tarisian ale, he says he can synthesize it and reproduce it in mass quantities. Problem is, I need one of those tack glands to make the first batch. And now that Taris is a smoking ruin, the only place to find tack is on Kashyyyk. If you can get your hands on one of those tack glands, I'll make it worth your while.
Okay, what's in it for me?
Sorry, like I said before, I don't have any credits on me, and Greta won't lend me any. I mean, it's like he doesn't trust me to pay him back or something. But you come through on this, and I promise you'll get a huge payday down the road. 3,000 credits. How's that sound?
Yeah, right. All right, I'll get them for you.
Yeah, I knew you'd come through for me. You won't regret this. You'll see, just don't take too long, okay? This guy from the exchange could stop by any day. I kind of told him I already had the stuff, so if he shows up and I'm empty-handed, well, let's just say I really, really hope it doesn't come to that.
Okay. Dude, some...
Greetings again from the offices of Zerka Corporation. Is this about bounties or something else?
I have gaffy sticks to redeem.
I see that, but do you have the all-important chieftain's gaffy? That was what you agreed to get for us.
There it is.
Well, that is a very big headache that you've removed. I'm sure there are still sand people out there, but they'll be quieter now. I think I'll give you a bonus for this. You've more than lived up to your side of the bargain. Zerka Corporation thanks you.
Do I persuade her with more or what? I can't remember. Additional reward, probably?
And I wouldn't want you to leave without this additional reward. Yes, of course I wouldn't.
Zerka may be a corrupt organization, but that does not justify us using the Force for personal gain.
See, that's why sometimes it's good. If you just persuade it, or it's different. We got 1,300 XP and 500 credits. So if you got the good Force people with you and you use your Force persuade, like, for gain, like that, sometimes it'll get yelled at. Okay, so what do we need to do now? We got to turn into the Jawas, right? Yeah, I think so. I don't know why I'm looking at this again. We got that done. So now we gotta head back to the Jawas, turn in that quest, and then really the only thing we got left to worry about is sand people. Because, Bastila's mother's quest is, oh, not sand people, sorry, what we have to worry about is the star map. Bastila's mother, the quest for that is actually in the same area as the star map. So we'll be doing all that in the next vid. But let's finish this one off first. I'm waiting for HK. I don't think we didn't really need him, but I was kind of curious to see how long it would take for him to get here. He takes a sweet ass time though, doesn't he? We can use that night speed. Apparently, obviously he doesn't have that. I think you see him coming up behind there. While we're talking. There it comes. Now, if we, we get an Achani, I think we get an Achani shield thing for their arms from them for the extra reward. If we would have went the dark side path, we would not have obviously been able to learn about the star map from the sand people, because we would have killed them all. So actually, when we come back here, we can ask the Jawa about the, and we still would have freed their people by doing that. So we come here and we ask him about it, and he'll tell us where it's at. But the sand people already told us where it was. I think I asked him about the star map just to see if he gives us anything different info-wise. But yeah, he tells us basically it's in the same spot as the same people told us. So, we already knew it. And a map. He would have gave us a map for the Eastern Dunes, and the same people gave us a map already, so. What else? Crate dragons. Alright, tells us there's a Twi'lek hunter who knows about crate dragons, possibly. Okay, so that's it. We're done. So we're gonna head out to the Eastern Dune Sea and work on getting that star map and figuring out what's up with this crate dragon in the next video. So, thanks for watching, everybody, and we'll see you guys all in the next one. Take care.